Isaiah 6:1 says, "In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple." Often, as Isaiah did in our scripture reading, we hear people refer to particular years in their lives that major happenings took place. Maybe they speak of the year that they were married. Maybe they speak of the time of the birth of a child. Sometimes we hear folks referencing something tragic as a divorce or something devastating as a house fire or a death in the family. Well, this is exactly what the prophet Isaiah is doing when he starts out the verse with, "In the year that King Uzziah died." We find that not just one major crisis occurred in that year for Isaiah, but multiple things. The previous chapter tells us of the devastating effects of the sins of the children of Israel who were not fearing God nor his judgment. What God said was good, they were calling it evil. What God called evil, they were saying it was all right. And they boasted of their evil doings and made bold statements that God could do as he desired in bringing judgment against them. They didn't fear what he could do. So not only in this particular year Isaiah spoke of did the king die, but he was dealing with the devastating moral decay of humanity. His surrounding culture was engrossed in vile sins and extreme wickedness. So you may ask, what was the issue that the prophet pointed to the year a king died? All men die sooner or later, right? And while this is true, King Uzziah's death was untimely and a very tragic event. The Bible says in 2 Chronicles chapter 26 that the prophet Isaiah was the scribe responsible for writing down the events of King Uzziah's life. He had written down that this king was only 16 years old when he began his reign. Uzziah is known for being the second longest reigning king in the Bible. He prayed and led God's people in great military victories with a host of fighting men. He built towers and dug wells, many wells of water. His fame spread far and wide, for God marvelously helped him to do great things. Uzziah did that which was right in the sight of the Lord for 52 years. And keep in mind, the prophet Isaiah is the one that's writing this all down. But the excitement of this man's remarkable life changed in 2 Chronicles chapter 26. This chapter reveals that when the king was strong, his heart was lifted up in pride to his destruction. Uzziah committed a great offense toward God. It was never the place of the king to burn incense on the altar of incense. Only the priest could do this. Azariah the priest went in after him along with 80 other priests of the Lord to discourage Uzziah from committing this great offense. But he only grew outraged and in total disobedience. He went into the altar and committed a trespass that God would not tolerate. Instantly, this king who had been righteous for over 5 decades was smitten with the deadly disease of leprosy. After pages and pages of good deeds, Isaiah had to be the one to finish Uzziah's life story by writing that he died a leper. How tragic that year was for the prophet Isaiah. Sin was rampant. Then on top of that, the extraordinary story of the second longest reigning king was lost to defeat and failure. The prophet is remembering that particular year of devastation. But thankfully, in Isaiah chapter 6, in the year of Uzziah's downfall, Isaiah had an encounter that changed his whole perspective. He said, "I saw also the Lord. He was high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple." Everywhere Isaiah could see, the Lord's glorious train displayed victories upon victories. And regardless of the sin and the culture and the disobedience of the passing king, God was sitting upon the throne, lifted above all competition and contradiction. And around the throne, the seraphims were crying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts." The seraphims were saying, "The whole earth is full of his glory." And this holy cry got the attention of this broken-hearted, tired, and weary prophet. All he was seeing was the defeat in the earth. And at this glorious sight, Isaiah cries out, "Woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." The seraphim flew over to him with a live coal off the altar and laid it on Isaiah's lips. God saw Isaiah's desire for a change of mindset and a renewed vision of who God is despite his surroundings. From that vision of the King of Kings, Isaiah was refreshed and restored in the power of God. When God asked, "Who can I depend on to fulfill my mission?" Isaiah quickly said, "God, don't look any farther. Here I am. Send me. Use me to preach your word. Use me to fulfill your mission in any way you choose." Friend, in these days of so much trouble, it's easy only to see the chaos in our world around us. It's easy to focus on the disappointing news we hear every day. You can become so discouraged in the ones that you've had confidence in that has let you down as King Uzziah did to Isaiah. But if you will look up, you too can see God in his glory, still sitting upon his throne, high and lifted up. Regardless of what's happening in our world today, the whole earth is still full of his glory. God is still all powerful and in control. So may I encourage you today, look up, lift up your eyes to the heavens where our soon coming King is ready to give you a refreshing and a renewing to your troubled spirit as he did Isaiah. We need to be asking for an Isaiah encounter. We need to experience a transition in what we see so we can better serve our master till he returns. God bless you, and may you receive an Isaiah encounter even today.